Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2381, how to subtotal by both ID and name. Great question from Kara in my Akron webinar this week. I need a subtotal by both ID and name. Currently, Kara is concatenating them in a temporary column, adding the subtotals, but then she needs to break it back into two columns. It's just a lot of steps. Is there something quicker? Let's take a look. Oh, great question today from Kara, who is subtotaling data and needs to subtotal by both ID and customer. Right now, she's concatenating those together. I don't know if my method will be much faster. So we're gonna do data subtotal at each change in ID. Choose the four numeric fields out there, click OK. All right, now check this out. The problem here is that 12027 total appears, but we don't have the word ABC stores in column F. So I'm gonna go to the number two view. I'm gonna choose all of those cells in column F, and then Alt semicolon to select visible cells. Now currently, I have to look over here on the left-hand side and see that I'm currently in F6. I wanna grab the customer name from just above me. So I'm gonna very carefully here type equal F5, and that formula is gonna be different every day. From this point, press Ctrl Enter, right? And check out what just happened. I brought the customer name down into this cell. Here, let's look at that one. We'll expand back to the number three view. I brought the word AT&T down into that current cell, and so on. From there, we've got it, right? We're just gonna select all this data, Alt semicolon, Control C, Control N for new, Control V to paste, and we're good to go. I don't know, Kara, is that faster? Now look, everyone, Kara has been in my seminars in Akron, Ohio many times before, and Kara doesn't understand that the folks at this YouTube channel are all screaming at us right now because we're not using Power Query, particularly if the ID and customer could be different. So the same ID could have different customer names and you would need two lines. They're all gonna say that we should be using Power Query. So to do that, we're gonna do Control T, and I understand how much we hate to do Control T because now we can no longer do subtotals. Then on the data tab, we're gonna say from table or range, we're gonna click on ID, control click on customer, transform, group by. So ID and customer, we're gonna add a new column called quantity. And the operation is going to be the sum of quantity. Add another aggregation, total revenue, sum, why does autocomplete not work there? Of revenue, total cost of goods sold. Now I know this is like 400 more steps than the subtotal, and Kara's already just shaking her head. The beautiful thing though is once we do this once, it will be able to do this again and again and again, provided we can just paste the new data back over that table. So while this certainly seems like it takes a lot longer, it will, in the long run, be a faster way to go. I got a great note back from Kara. She says she's gonna use both of these. If it's something she's gonna repeat a lot, she'll use Power Query. Otherwise, she'll just do the quick and dirty method one. Thanks to Kara for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.